Oh, maybe come on, Ice Cube.
Welcome, everyone. Oh. Okay, okay, I'm spectating now. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for joining us.
And we're off.
No, not yet. There's not that much lag, actually.
Right, okay, I'm going to jump on board with Albert's right at the
front. I'm going with the Cooker.
Well, I am going to go then. You said you're going to go with Cooker. Just wait before you start. Where does Cooker start from? He's from 13th. Okay, I will then go on Wasim.
Right.
In the Audi
Good
TT.
Good choice.
Ooh, that is interesting.
If any of the races are watching, good luck, guys.
Let's do it.
I can hear the music. It's a good start.
I can
His
hear
first
cars, really.
Sequence of corners. Come on. Okay, and lights out. Here we go.
Cook has made up a few places. Oh, some guys breaking extremely hard into first corner. Others not so much. Oh, Lord, getting pit maneuvered here a bit.
Oh, and we've got like someone, Cooker already sideways.
Yeah, no.
I caught all of that. I'm going to jump a bit forward and see what racing we can see.
I've got Wasim behind Colossus Wolf going through Eau Rouge, getting to Kemmel Street.
Lots of different lines through Eau Rouge there.
Oh, someone's
out
on the grass. Someone's still stuck on the grass. Ooh, the whole back straight. Well, this straight on the grass anyway.
Spring Congo TT. Oh, this is absolute carnage.
Oh,
oh my word, something's just happened at the end of the first
Cashel
straight.
Chris straight
Dan
into
there as well.
Oh my word.
Oh, no.
People squitting out.
Oh, that's definitely a DC. Oh, what on earth?
No, no. I think it's people quitting out.
Who have we just
from
lost?
Too much damage. So we've lost.
Oh, no. Colossus I'm looking.
Cashel.
Colossus Wolf.
Isn't it? Is it Colossus?
Was it? Well, we'll have to double check that. Flipping out. Well, someone created absolute carnage at the end of the straight, so I can only assume that was him.
I'm keeping an eye on the group. There's no action there just yet. Just Colossus.
I'm following the
so
pack.
Far.
Yeah, I'm looking back from Albert.
I think it might have
just
been lagged.
Just gone. Oh, that fast left hander there.
Oh my word.
Big flip is off. Ooh. And Wally is trying to get through as well. Wally and Isaac Blom having a bit of a battle. Lambo versus Lambo. Ooh, Isaac Blom sideways, holding Wally up a little. Wally on the outside. Can he do it? Ooh, it's opened the gap for a big flippy to come on the inside. Definitely giving enough space for everyone to race each other.
I didn't notice, but Pierce Nears is actually pulling away in the lead at the moment.
Ooh.
I was expecting Alberts to catch him much quicker, but he's actually disappearing.
Join Nerdy Knuckles and see what's cracking in his Corvette. Got a bit of space. Ooh, Ezekiel almost losing it on the exit of the last corner. Getting some good drift angle there.
So I've just jumped on board with Sonny Mammal. He's at the back of all the action and see what he can do.
Corvette's looking good of Nutty Knuckles, actually. Some really good-looking cars out. Ooh, little extension of the corner there. Corvette does need it. Seems to be struggling a bit down the back end. Or top end, at least. Let's see what's happening by Wasim.
I think it relies heavily on its tyre temperature, doesn't it, the Corvette? Just to get its power down. Oh, nice, they are, eh?
Wasim is actually catching caustic here.
Pierce is locking in, locking up a bit. Now we've got Albert and Sick and chasing him down.
This is close here between 3rd, 4th and 5th. And we've got Lambo, Porsche and R8. It's fantastic to see.
Oh,
someone's TT's going to make a move on Caustic.
No, it's from Albert. Albert is off into the wall.
But that was weird. What bizarre, because his rear wing just came off, and then next thing he lost control. That was very strange.
Yeah, that
Let's see that in action replay.
If only we had that option.
Yeah, yeah.
That is so strange. He's gone from second all the way down to seventh already.
That was bizarre. Extremely bizarre. His wing just came off mid-corner and then lost control of the car.
And Piesny has
anyway,
going
so
well in
now,
first.
This is no longer a battle for third, fourth, and fifth. It's actually for second, third, and fourth. So Piesny is just disappearing into the distance at the moment.
Now we've got Raikkonen chasing him down. Raikkonen currently in second. So he was 5 seconds behind.
Wazin and Caustic Raccoons decided they want to get in on the action now. They've seen what's happened with Albert's dropping out, and they're smelling points.
Oh, Sprinkon over cooking the hip.
Oh,
and
on
there.
The inside.
And PSNS is doing a good job because Raikkonen is still keeping that gap only to 5 seconds. He's not pulling him back.
He's doing a great job. Well, for anyone watching, if you don't know, we have a reverse grid policy. So basically, the guys who finished at the front of the last race are now starting from the back. So the form would say that the quicker guys should be working their way through. But here we've got Piers Nierse disappearing into the distance. It's fantastic.
And we've got Sprinkon now down into fourth position, and he's trying to find a way past Sunny Mammal. He's doing everything he can in that Lambo.
There's a proper battle with Sim and Caustic, though. Ooh, TT's going on the inside. Can he make it work? Ooh.
Ooh. Well, I've been on board with Sonny Mammal for almost a full lap now, and I'm very impressed with what this R8 can do. It's not struggling at all.
Well,
R8 is a very solid car, though.
The R8...
Yeah, it's got it everywhere.
...has been proven to be a very good
like
car.
Like someone's on the grass there.
Oh, Sprinkon showing us what he can do other than
bit
racing.
Drifts, yeah.
And that's giving Wasim an opportunity. Sprinkon drifting again and off the track. Oh, my word.
Wasim is fourth,
Caustic
scoring
is
there
come
a bit with that.
Through as well into fifth position. Sprinkon not letting that position go, both side by side.
Raikkonen has just lost his drive going onto the back straight, and it looks like this Sunny Mammal could actually take him here just on pure power because he got a nice exit from the last corner. Ooh.
Well, there was a bit of a gap, but let's see if he can close that gap down.
I got into the chicane. They're on top of each other.
It's
close. Let's see. Again, you can get the power down first. Looks like Sonny Mammal. He's got that R8 really hooked up. And if you look into the distance, they can see Piers Nierse as well there. So they can see that P1 is on the table.
See, the Audi should take him. Yeah, Rav.
He's driving fantastic.
A
so
bit of leg,
far.
Actually.
Yeah. I see Wazin still is in fourth there, just in the distance. Wonder if he can close the gap. Isn't he in the TT
yet? Raikkonen's drifting as well.
Again, going onto the straight, so he's going to lose all of
this
drive.
And this is
going to
give Sunny Mammal a brilliant run at him. He's on the outside, but it looks like Raikkonen's running very little downforce because he's actually gaining speed. Sunny breaking a bit late and blocking.
Oh, and Wazin's on top of them.
This is going to be a.
But we know this TT is super fast through this section.
Just a quick fun fact here. So, Sunny Mammal is actually the brother of Ninecop.
There we go. Keeping it in the
family. We know Ninecop's no slow. Bit of a battle going on for 9th and 8th as well.
Is,
it's like Blob and Wally.
Control that Porsche. Oh, Wazin on the outside. He almost pulled that off. What an ambitious move that was. Fantastic.
This is a very brilliant three-way battle. I'm actually just scared to move away from this battle.
Yeah. Ooh. Well, I've checked that. This is the closest battle there.
Raikou-san is struggling for traction.
So Ezekiel saying, "Hi guys, I got a DC. Is unfortunate."
Oh no.
Well, currently your teammate is doing very well. He's currently running in first position, and he's actually keeping the gap up.
Yeah, they're all pretty. That Porsche has definitely got the speed in the straights, but he's struggling for traction in the corners desperately.
Are you talking about Raikou-san?
We've got some feedback on the stream.
Yeah, Raikou-san. Oh, on the brakes, the R8 closed right up. And so did Wazin in the TT.
So, PSNS has already got a 10-second gap.
Too much curb. Wazin's got a chance now to go past, has he? No, the R8's stopped it too much.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, he's on the outside.
Should be interesting.
No. Well, now it's going to be who's got the drive-through. Rouge
and the TT seems very fast down top end, so it's going to be close.
It is. It's a good handling car as well. But again, Piers Nees is just cruising away at the moment. He's loving all of this.
Got a feedback. Ask management, just pump your game volume up a bit. And then our voices are scratchy on Gary's stream. See, there was lag, because now Sean's even saying my stream is lagging. Your stream is jittery, Gary. Okay.
Right.
And on the party chat, I think. I don't know how to fix that.
Okay, so I've pumped up the
I assume it might be server problems there.
So we've still got Wasim behind Sunny Mammal. I want to see what the rest of the guys are up to. So we've got Sprintcon in fifth position. That drifting works that he showed us definitely cost him a bit. And he's got Raccoon right behind him. Well, not right behind him, but there's a gap of 1 second.
It's still a three-way battle to the side.
to catch up.
Must say the turbo on the TT does sound cool. It's quite a nice change from all the other cars.
Yeah, it is.
We've got Nutty Knuckles currently running in seventh position in the Corvette. Volley will be disappointed. He's currently running in eighth position. And he's also running the Lambo. He was braking on the exit of the corner, almost basically locking his brakes up. Remington saying, "Good evening, gents. Come on, Wasim." So we've got some Wasim fans in here as well.
Well, Wasim's doing fantastic. Yeah.
Yeah,
he's putting on a proper battle. Third position, well, second position.
Yeah.
Kuka is driving in ninth position.
Oh, no. Bit of contact there, but it should be good. Nothing intentional.
Isaac Blom in
Sunny Mammal.
Another Lambo running wide all the track in 11th place, almost taking out Albert. That was very close. So Albert, with his lost wing, he's gone down to 11th place now.
That was a very strange
situation.
Might
have been in the pits, though.
Well, Danadu is still running around in 14th position.
So now we've got Wazin on Raikou-san.
And
he's taking him on the inside.
Nicely.
Oh, he gave it back. Oh, okay. He felt he impeded him.
I'm remembering last
year. Well done
year,
for going for it.
With when we finished the year off with the GT3 cars. Danadu actually was running also in the R8. And his team was called the no-name brand or the no-name pick and pay team or something like that, and I'm looking at his car and it is almost using the exact same colors as back then. That's very Danadu almost took out Sunny Mammal. Gary, you forgot to put the cars on ghost mode for the back markers. Then I'd be getting out of the way. Well. Oh, we're going to have some guys complaining again.
I think we should just stick
again.
To them. They must know now.
Oh, Sunny Mammal's running wide there on the exit.
Oh, my word.
And Wazzy's looking like he can take Raku Sunny.
The TT's fast.
It's
no
extremely quick.
On the straights, yeah.
Maybe struggling a little out of the exit because it's front. Ooh, he's right on the back. He can get fast.
You can get him now on the brakes if he takes him into the chicane. Oh, where's he going? Where's he going?
But if he can make this work.
Raku Sunny's going defensive.
Yeah. Oh, Wazzy has hit my wall.
Can you believe it?
Wasim has hit my wall.
Oh, no.
And he's just got cubed. I think he keeps stalling here.
Oh,
this is damage.
That is so important.
No, that is damage.
At least he's close to
that's hard damage here.
Oh.
Yeah, it's very big damage. You can hear the engine sputtering.
Yeah,
there.
I know. He's...
But that was... like...
Oh, he hit it exactly the same way as I hit that wall. That was so unfortunate.
Oh, again, Raikou-san getting a bit wild through Rouge. Oh, he's struggling to keep that back still.
And Piersnius is still going at it, not looking back. He's got a lead
of 13
seconds now. And Sunny Mammal is closing the gap back to Raikou-san again. Now, Raikou-san is definitely defending very well. He's putting the car in the middle of the track and no one can pass him.
Yeah, he's working hard, you can see that.
Yes. And as soon as he makes a mistake, Sunny Mammal is going to get past. You can definitely see that.
Well, I don't know, he's been doing well for the last, what, 4 or 5 laps
and
now?
And there's the mistake.
As I say it, there it is.
And
there it is.
Sunny Mammal had to avoid that going wide off track.
I wonder if he's going to use his pits to get past.
He has to.
He's already back on him, so I don't think it'll be too difficult. He's going to have to wait maybe for another mistake.
Let's see.
See who's got the better drive down the straight.
Let's see up to the chicane.
He's got the line.
What happens?
Sunny Mammal definitely having a smoother line through that last section.
He needs to try and stay on the power though. He just lets off just before the end of the corner.
You see, this is where it becomes interesting because Raikou-san has definitely gone with a very low downforce setup because you can actually see him pulling away on the straight. He already went into the race with the mentality of
he's followed him into the pits.
I'm gonna be fast on the straights and then I'm just gonna slow everyone down on the corners, and that is exactly what he is doing.
It's worked so far.
I'm on board with
the joint front.
I want to see this battle out of the pits here.
This recognizable Goofster Racing, is it?
Yes,
livery
it
we
is.
Have from Piersnius.
From Piersnius, yeah, he is racing for Goofster's team.
Representing.
Remington saying, no man, Wasim, still time. You should be calm and wait for the opportunity. Oh, and Sunny Mammal is way too early on the power on the exit of the pit. And he has definitely lost a bit of time now.
Yeah, he's lost a lot of ground.
Yeah. He was
that's
on
so
the
smooth
power
through the
way
roof.
Too early.
I'm going to give Piersnius some Hollywood cameras.
I'm sure you'll appreciate it.
Well, Piersnius, like I said, currently he is doing a brilliant job in staying in the front.
He looks quite comfortable.
Yes, he is. He's locking up his brakes here and there, going into the corners, but he's not going off track. And that is a good sign. As long as he's keeping it on the black stuff, he shouldn't have any problems.
Yeah, he's got quite a lead now. It's going to take something special to catch up.
Well, before Rikus unpitted, the gap was already at 13 seconds.
Yeah.
Now Pearson is coming to the chicane here. Yeah? And he's going straight into the pit.
Yeah, he's gone in. Right. Okay. So let's jump on. Oh, we've got Caustic
in
second.
We've actually got a Raccoon that went past Sprungcon. And Sprungcon hasn't pitted yet.
And a good-looking Ferrari as well. I like it.
And you know what? The Ferraris has been a surprise package.
They have. They have.
I mean, if you look at...
I've been trying them out recently. It's a very nice car.
No, like I said, it's just very difficult to get them to be hooked up. But as soon as you have them hooked up, it's one of the best cars to drive.
On the longer tracks, it just loses out. But on the mid and shorter tracks, it's actually a weapon. It is very good. Easy to handle through the corners and the twisty bits.
Well, with the next track coming up at Yas Marina, Kyle Williams has already laid down a marker by doing a 2-11.
Yeah, well, he's shown, hasn't he, what it can do. Yeah. He's put in a real good performance.
So Pearson has went into the pits. He came out and he is still second. He came out between a Raccoon and a Sprungcon, yeah, and both these still needs to pit. Oh, Sprungcon is drifting. He's definitely struggling with the Lambo. But as everyone
just
saw
like
this
to get
track,
it sideways, though.
As everyone saw this track, everyone knew the Lambo wasn't going to fare too well on
Sprungcon
this track.
Still drifting. Ooh, on the grass. Oh, and he was just making up some good space or time not to Pierce Nears there.
Raikou is currently in fourth position, and he's lost Sunny Mammal. Is Sunny? Did he go to the pits again? He's gone down to 10th now.
Yeah, something's happening. Yeah. Wazim's in fifth.
Maybe he's had a mistake. Yeah.
He's definitely
had a
mistake. Beyond
Olmitz, took the early pits, I think.
No, because if you look at the gap between Wasim...
I think we must have had a couple of guys that have pitted early. So it's kind of messed up with
the
positions
a little
bit.
Yeah, but Sunny Mammal came out of the pit behind Raikou's son. And he was only like 3 or 4 seconds behind him. And now currently he's 16 seconds behind...
Yeah, we've got Volley in Albert's. Sixth, but Albert's in ninth. Yeah, Albert's is in front of him. So, yeah, something's happened.
Yeah, he's definitely put it again.
No, was there a black screen? Did we lose someone else?
Oh,
someone else has moved back.
Volley.
Who is it? No.
Yep,
Volley is out.
Oh, flipping heck. It's not frame drops, it's DCs.
10 laps into the race. Now we've got Aster saying, let's go Wasim. Well, it seems I've got a lot of Wasim fans here in the chat. So yeah, if you guys are just joining, he actually made a huge mistake in the chicane. And it cost him a very early pit. He had a lot of damage.
Now I'm with Pierce Nears at the moment. It's coming on the back of Caustic Raccoon. Now, if I'm not mistaken, he needs to pit this time around, doesn't he?
No. Remember, these guys don't have pit windows.
They can pit
any time.
Yeah, that's right. So they just have two mandatory pits, but they can choose when. Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, And Caustic Raccoon didn't pit earlier in the race, did he? Because that would throw a spanner in.
No, I don't think he's gone in.
This is actually for position.
Yeah, I think this is the first stint, basically.
Oh, Pierceness has gained some distance on him there. Oh, he's gone a bit wide, though. Right, Caustic Raccoon's gone in now. Okay, there we go.
He's missing the AM racing days. Oh, Volley, that is unfortunate that your game... Did the game crash, or did you actually disconnect out of the game?
Okay, let's jump on board with Spring Khan.
Oh man, that is so unfortunate that your game actually crashed.
Ooh, we got a bit of a tussle there. Looked like on turn.
Well, yeah, turn one.
Turn one, actually, yeah.
Yeah, we had Wasim and Raccoon, actually, but Raccoon still needs to pit, I believe.
Well, I've just jumped on board with Wasim now. He's definitely the man on the move in fourth place. Mm. He's looking down the barrels.
He did a 2.18.9.
Yeah. Wow, really?
Yeah, he's got fastest lap at the moment.
That is very good. I'm going to stay on board here. It looks like he's catching very quick. Tyres seem to have made his car quicker.
Volley saying Wasim is podium material today. Well, he has been driving very good. He's made some silly mistakes, and again today in the race he hit the inside barrier at the chicane. So yeah, that's definitely. And we've got Piesnius behind Danadu coming to lap him. Piesnius is doing a fantastic job today. He seems unstoppable at this stage.
I want to see if Wasim can stitch all these laps together from now till the end. I think he could do some serious damage on this.
But no mistakes.
Well,
he's
already on the back of Raikou-san.
Yeah.
He's right on the back of him now.
Putting pressure.
And this is all happening.
And he's going on the,
on the
inside.
Well done. Well done.
Raikou-san through the sand. That's
well, Raikou-san has got the top end. Let's see if Raikou-san can get back.
Yeah, but could you see the difference in Wasim's behavior this time? He wasn't hanging around. He was just saying, listen, let me through. Before,
is it the same driver that came
track
out the pits? That is
no,
my
exactly
question.
It's amazing. He's gone.
He's definitely...
The stick.
Yeah, exactly. He just needs to stay away from the walls, and then he should be good. Well, he can actually get off to... Piesnius about now, depending on how
but
far
that's what I'm
he
saying
is.
If he can stitch these laps together now from now until the end, which is very doable, it's only what 13 laps.
Well, he's
he can do some damage
position.
Yeah,
with
I think we should definitely
third
keep an eye on this.
Well, he's 20 seconds behind the leader. He's found
there's still quite a few
in
laps. It's half, yeah, basically halfway through the race.
But look at the gap he's pulled. This time, last time around, it was probably the same distance from Raikou-san. And he's completely reversed that in one lap. So,
well, Volley, if he can keep his concentration, he's definitely in it to win it. But it all depends on if he's going to keep on up his concentration.
This TT really is a surprising little package. Oh, who's that? Xanadu?
Very strong.
Oh. Yo, that could have been very bad.
Oh. Well, he's well avoided that. Didn't lose too much time. This is it. Lovely.
So we've
lovely
got
lines.
Piesnius doing a 2 minute 22, and Wasim's last lap was a 2 minute 20. So that's effectively
sure,
2 seconds a lap that he's catching him up on. So there's definitely
a lot
the opportunity to catch him.
He just needs to put the pressure. He just needs to get close enough that he knows he's there. And
yes,
then he could still make a mistake, you see, and then anything can happen.
Well, I can tell you now, the guy that will be kicking himself is the Sunny Mammal. He was doing brilliant.
Yeah, I wonder what happened.
We still
there.
Don't know what happened, but
we should start getting the drivers back in the chat after the race so we can ask them questions. Because he just seemed to disappear. He was going in P3
like what went
and then
wrong.
All of a sudden,
yes.
Yeah.
Got a bit of a battle forming with Alberts and Nutty Knuckles as well. The next few corners, we should see Alberts catching him.
We know Alberts is super smooth and super quick, so he
yeah,
can
he's
also...
just out of practice at this stage, but he is definitely he's a very good driver. I mean, he is a former pro driver for this group, and we all know what he is capable of.
With ease,
And he's driving on the wheel, so he is very fast, considering that he is doing it from the
I
wheel.
I think he's the only one on the wheel now. Because Vian is not racing anymore.
No, there's actually a couple of guys running on wheel. I believe Isaac Blom is also in on a wheel.
Is he? Okay.
And well, I believe maybe Nutty Knuckles as well. I'm not too sure. I'll double check.
I know Derivo was once upon a time, but I think he
it would be nice if Nutty Knuckles is because Nutty Knuckles and Alberts are having their own battle. And then there's like a wheel battle.
Yeah, having that rig races only was a cool race. That was fun.
No, we have to. I'm definitely planning on us doing it again. But I think we will not plan it for the Saturday morning. We will do it for a Saturday afternoon. To see if we can get more guys involved. The Saturday
there was a scheduling conflict, wasn't there?
Yeah.
With rugby or something.
No. People thought we were scheduling it for the night, and then we started a race in the morning.
Oh.
So they didn't actually check
it was quite
if it
early,
was AM
as well,
or PM. Yeah, because it was 9 a.m. But it was a good race. I think everyone enjoyed it.
That was fun.
Well, the guys that actually participated.
Yeah.
It's a pity the wheels are still so expensive. You thought now like that the Xbox One has been out for so long that the prices would have come crashing down.
Yeah.
They are still.
Yeah, because
they're
already promoting the new one, aren't they? Yeah.
Yeah. Now, I wonder if it's going to be actually compatible with the Xbox Two or Scarlet or whatever it's called.
That would be the nail in the coffin, that wouldn't it? You finally get your dream rig, and then it's like, sorry, not compatible.
Next.
No. Yeah. Okay, so previous
Please
lap.
Buy another 7, right?
PSNS 222, Wasim 219. So that's
a three second
gap that he's just pulled in.
This is very doable. I'm going to pull up the map. I need to see this. Where are we? Come on. Right. So
Wasim's
it's basically the length of this straight, isn't it? The distance.
Yeah.
So Wazin's just going through El Rouge now, and Pierce Nears is coming to the end of the straight. Yeah, so that's the distance. So I'm going to keep the map up, and then we can actually monitor this distance, see if it can come down.
Well, he's 800 meters.
We've got 13 seconds.
Perfect. There we go. Ice cube.
Everything we need. Yeah.
It was 700 meters. Now everyone is willing Wasim on.
I bet there's a lot more guys willing to try the TT as well after this.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's definitely the underdog, but I mean, it can cope. Obviously, you're going to struggle a little on the pull-off part of the race, but other than that, you should be sorted.
Well, the TT is a very good car, and it's a bit easier to set up because it is front-wheel drive. So your setup is basically going to be almost the same as what you would have done for the touring cars.
I think the key with it is to keep the momentum. It's not very good if you lose the momentum. It's not very quick at getting started again. But if you can keep the thing moving, you get into a rhythm, it can be very, very quick.
Ooh, 9 and 10th. 9th has just come out in front. Ooh, Alberts and Nutty Knuckles again. No, Big Flippy actually batting me out. Alberts just coming out the pits.
Well, that will be his second
call the
pit.
Tires.
So Alberts will be running down to the line now. What's that? 11 laps.
Okay, so coming
it's
to
not
the
bad.
Back straight.
Tires should be good.
Wasim started on 800 meters behind.
Yeah. Oh, who's that? It's just gone off.
No, Danadu is trying to get out the way. Danadu is getting well out of the way. Well done, Danadu.
Well done. Yeah, very good.
Yeah, Wally definitely DC'ing at 630 kilometers an hour. So. Maybe Orlando, that's why he got kicked out.
Do it in style.
He was cheating.
Ooh, right, we go. Let's check this distance now. So Wazim is just about to go through Eau Rouge again.
And there's only an 11.8 second gap. So he's caught up another
piece. He's nowhere near the end of the straight. Oh, he's probably carved about a third of that distance out. That just in one lap.
It's made a difference.
This is very doable. I'm getting excited.
Well, last lap from Wasim again at 2:19, and PSNS again at 2:22.
Right. Well, he's going to be feeling the pressure now.
So
he'll
he's
be
definitely
checking his
catching 3 seconds a lap, and I believe
he's caught another 1 second already. Is it already at 9.8 seconds? It was 11 point something at the start of the lap.
10
seconds. It's crashing. It's tumbling down, actually.
And he's learned this time as well not to dither. If he gets the opportunity, he must take it.
Yeah. 9.5 seconds. It's really another half a second.
But Pearson has just had to get past the back marker, though, according to the map. So that could have held him up slightly.
This is very interesting. Well, I want to quickly run through the guys from the back. So you still got Danadu running in the 13th position. And then we've got Isaac Blom actually turned around. He has got some damage. He's heading back to the pits again. We've got
that is a shame.
Casual Chris running in 11th. So let's see.
Oh, flat out.
Casual Chris is actually in the McLaren.
Someone going the wrong way.
Yeah, that is Isaac Blom. He crashed and he's getting back to the pits again.
That is a long lap.
So Casual Chris, I'm actually surprised. I haven't seen anyone in the McLaren in a very long time. And Casual Chris actually...
What's Wazim going to do here? Can you get through Eau Rouge together? Yeah, no problem. Nicely. Oh, lovely. Now he's got the driver and Casual Chris.
Yeah, he's Casual Chris over. Getting
That's
out
it.
Of the way.
Okay, lovely.
That's
very
the best
nice.
Thing to do. Okay, so Albert is currently running in 10th position, still without the back wing that he lost very early on.
That was very bizarre.
Yeah, I still want to see what happened there. So Big Flippy currently running in 9th position. And then we've got Kuka 500 in his Audi running in 8th position.
Wazin's going to
start
seeing
7.3.
Him. I was going to say, you can see him. He just saw him turn the corner. This is it. The adrenaline's going to build up now. Keep it smooth, Wazin. You're doing a great job.
Nutty Knuckles in 7th position. And then Sunny Mammal, still I say he will be kicking himself for his mistake, whatever he did wrong. But he's currently running in 6th position. And then Sprung Corn and Raikou-san is having a battle. Raikou-san already dropping to 5th position.
I think he's definitely battling with the, like you said, the lower downforce
option.
Obviously with the track with so many corners as well. It's not maybe the best idea.
Yeah, because on the straights, he is super fast and no one is able to stick with him. But as soon as you get to this, and
Sprung Corn
drifting again. But as soon
both
as
of them actually drifting.
Raikou-san gets to the corners, you can see the back end is just sliding out. There's no downforce on the back.
I think we spoke about it in the pro race. The balance of the car is so important in this track, especially through Eau Rouge. It needs to be planted. You can't have any. If it breaks loose, forget it. You could end in the tires.
Yes. Now we've got Casual Chris now currently running in... Raccoon running in third position in a Ferrari. This is well done.
It's a good-looking Ferrari as well,
it
yeah.
It is. It's very good-looking. And he's just kept himself away from trouble. And, it's worked out for him. He's currently running in third.
Very nice.
Won't be sad with a podium.
Definitely not.
Sprinkhorn's still sideways again. Maintaining his
drift. For the first time in this race, Piers Nears could actually come under some pressure. Wonder if he's got anything in the locker room. Excellent, yeah.
And he's been doing his lap times consistently, and that's what's kept him in the lead so long. But with Wasim on a charge down... It's down to 5 seconds, 5.7 seconds. This is getting
the gap
close.
Is visible now.
Yeah, we still got Aster saying, keep it up, Wasim.
Put the pressure.
Ezekiel telling
this will
his,
be one heck of a drive.
His teammate, Piers Nears, keep your pace, teamy. You're racing against yourself, forget everyone else.
Big Flippy's back into 8th, so he's putting the pressure on. He's just got past Kuka, 500.
A volley all the way behind his teammate, Wasim. Saying,
Rekusan trying to take the inside line there, but Sprinkhorn keeping the inside. Rekusan probably make another dive for it. Being forced to the outside on the corner now. But like you said, that Porsche definitely has a good strong top end.
I think Rekusan pitted the previous lap, and that is why he went all the way down there, because his previous lap was at 2 minute 40 seconds.
That would make sense, yeah. Sprinkhorn still battling it out. Sprinkhorn opening a little bit of a gap. We'll see if he can maintain it.
Okay, so previous lap, PSS went 2:21 and Wasim 2:19, so... Piers has definitely got the hurry-up sign from his teammate.
Oh, he's on the grass. Wasim has gone wild there through a rouge. Got his line completely wrong.
I think too many of us...
Gap's at 4.6 seconds.
...had the opportunity to take a rouge completely wrong this last 2 weeks.
As long as you just stay away from the wall, it should be fine.
I think Wasim's putting himself under a bit of pressure, but he's right
can,
there.
He can see him. See Piers Nears right now.
I wonder if he can give him a surprise attack, although I bet he has been watching the distance come down.
Sprinkhorn, Kustik is coming out in a bit of the middle of the battle here.
Well, if Wasim can catch up to Piers Nears, it will either be he needs to pit first, or he needs to stay out a couple more laps.
Yeah, that's right. To try and undercut.
Ooh.
Rekusan's on the move. Let's see if he's good. He's not going to catch Sprinkhorn in time, though. Ooh, he's on the inside. Late braking. Ooh.
But I believe Sprinkhorn...
Oh, no, he's
Sprinkhorn
five,
was not expecting
five.
That.
Is that Piers Nears? In the gravel, so now Wasim is on the back of him. He should be in an overtaking position when it comes to the chicane.
Oh, he's very close now.
Yes, he is. He's lost that whole drive there. Although that GT4 is quite strong.
Second.
Oh, 70 meters now.
Ooh, Sprinkhorn very sideways and maybe losing it down straight. I don't see him anymore.
Oh, he's out in the pits.
Wasim going into the pit.
Right. No. Tactical.
Like I said, he's either going to have to pit immediately when he gets to the back of Piers Nears, or he needs to wait for Piers Nears to pit.
Sprinkhorn has
dizzy,
guys. Oh, and he was having such a good battle, man.
Looked like he lost it,
and then all of a sudden DC'd. So
now, Rekusan currently running in third again.
Yeah, now we're having such a good battle.
Well, I think Wesley may have made the correct decision here, because he could have spent the next couple of laps battling and losing time, whereas now he can get in, get some fresh tyres and just go straight to the finish line.
Exactly.
And caustic catching Reku-san. Ooh, as I said, that is a bit sideways. In one of the corners, you really don't want to lose it, like 250 k's an hour.
And I believe definitely both put pressure on Reku-san.
There you have, yes.
I think
this is for proper position.
Well, as the race went on, that Ferrari just got better and better.
Yeah, as the tires heat up, it just sticks. Especially through the
struggles down
the back of this first straight. Yeah.
The rest of the track, it's happy.
And we've got Volley saying that Wasim has just put enough pressure on Piersniers to force him into a mistake. And that was purely by Piersniers seeing the distance coming down.
That was it. Yeah. That was it. He felt the pressure. One small mistake and then he lost 3 seconds.
And it's so easy to do that.
Reku-san definitely extending his gap a bit down the straight. Caustic's going to have to work very hard to close the gap again.
So Wasim is only 29 seconds behind Piersniers. Is that enough for Piersniers to come out in front again? I don't think so. I think you need around 32
seconds.
We're going
to keep an eye on Piersniers. I want to see when he goes in. Oh no, he's crashed into the wall. He's crashed into the pit wall.
No!
And Piersniers has finally got into the pits. As I joined on him, he was actually in the pit wall. Word. So that's cost him a lot of time.
Definitely.
Easily 5 seconds.
Cost him a lot of time.
Don't see. Oh, I don't know if the camera is going to stop in time. Damn. If it stopped like maybe 2 garages down, I would have been able to see Wasim coming up.
Wasim's
going to get it,
line.
I think.
And he takes first position.
Other cars only just started moving. And hear him slaying. No, Wasim's got it.
Oh, Piersniers.
It would have been extremely close, though, if he didn't hit that pit wall, actually.
Right, so his plans worked then. He got in early, and now he can race down to the finish line. Let's see if Piersniers can do something here, because he has been at the front for the entire race.
Hmm?
No, we've got Aster saying well done.
It'd be nice to have a bit of a battle form. It's not over yet, though.
There's still 5 laps. Anything can happen. We're not cursing the race. We're just saying anything can happen.
Yeah.
We leave cursing to Rowan to do.
We've seen one ice cube today.
My speciality.
Sorry, Gary.
Too much of an inside line through that section. I've seen one ice cube will move, crash into the tire wall.
Oh, yes, yeah, I've already seen my move duplicated. Ezekiel's
opening the gap. Doing everything to try and stay with Wasim. You can see it in his language.
Ezekiel is saying, the pressure is on Wasim now. Well, we'll wait and see if Wasim can break this this 2 second barrier. Then it's going to be a bit of a different story.
What a terrific drive, though. To come from behind like this. I mean, we were at, what was it, lap 10, and we thought, is it even possible? And now here we are, lap 20.
And it's happened. But Piersniers also driving extremely well. I mean, I didn't see any really big mistakes from him other than
He's still there. He's not letting go.
There's a 33-second gap between Reku and Piersniers. So that's pretty much a whole pit, actually.
Yeah, that is an extra pit.
It looks like Albert's natural position in this race is in P9.
It's extremely good. It's doing very well with those wheels.
Well,
I'd like to give it a try. I don't think I've actually used a wheel on the Xbox One yet.
He's actually not too far behind Nutty Knuckles. Oh, and there's...
Oh, 0.3. I think he's going to get it.
There was just, that's just a all the lag gap come down. In the game that saw Nutty Knuckles stop dead in the road and next minute just moving again. That was creepy.
Join the battle now. We can see what happened. See if Albert can put some pressure. And steal himself an 8th place. I think Nutty Knuckles is going to make it too easy for him, though.
Albert usually uses his smooth driving style to get past. Mm. It's like he's extremely a Sunday consistent. Driver.
That's his strength,
oh, yeah.
So. Looks like he's right on the back of Nutty Knuckles. Let's see if Nutty Knuckles is going to go defensive or not. No need just yet. Just too much of a gap.
Yes, Nius is not giving up on P1.
Through Le Rouge. Albert's Nutty Knuckles seem pretty clean through there. Can't see with his camera view though. Nutty Knuckles opened the gap actually a bit.
Looking back, and Pierce Nies is losing a lot of time getting his power down.
Ooh. A bit wiggly on the exits or what?
Yeah, just that vital moment, you know, where you need it to bite, it's spinning up all the time.
Ooh.
Whereas Wazin seems to enjoy that TT, just flooring it everywhere.
Oh, and we've got Albert on the grass, actually.
No. Yeah, it seems to run a little wide now. Losing a bit more time to Nutty Knuckles.
So we've got a bit of feedback here from Volley saying that Wasim is actually in the front wheel drive Audi, so he didn't even convert it to all wheel drive.
It's good for a power point of view because it does actually let you have a bit more fun.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. And it's a lot lighter as well.
Yeah.
Pierce Nies has done a 2:20, so he's beaten his own personal best by 2 seconds, trying to stay on with Wazin.
It's good.
Oh, Albert's losing it.
Oh, ooh, I was word. Just going to check the gap in the next lap.
And
like a proper loss
gone.
As well.
He is.
Oh, is he backed out?
He is
yeah.
gone.
No.
Yes. Well, Danad is the one smiling right now because Danad is just picking off these. These guys' positions, basically.
Extra points.
All right.
Yeah, definitely. Isaac Blom going into the pits. He's currently running in a 10th position. And Casual Chris is still running in a 9th. And I'm catching Nutty Knuckles here as he goes through Eau Rouge, heading up to Camel Strait. That Corvette sounds freaking awesome.
Wazin looks like he's got this one now.
I'm gonna jump on board.
Gaps extend to 3.7, you might have a point.
You guys can
two and a half laps to go.
Corvette just I think it has to be the best sounding car in the GT3 class.
Oh, the racing V8. Oh, awesome. Nothing sounds better.
This car just sounds fantastic. I'm gonna run through the cars from first place and then you guys can tell me which car sounds best.
All evenly spaced around the track, it seems.
Volley saying he's in the full drive. This lobby has been unforgiving tonight. And then also
definitely seems a bit like a tough match.
And Wasim has broken PSNS. He's got this now, just to bring home in one piece.
Gap's at 5.2 now, so they're definitely right. And then out of a lap and a bit, he's extended by another 1.5 seconds.
Just needs to keep his concentration.
On board here with PSNS from his bonnet. To the chicane. You can definitely hear he was lifting for that.
Big Flippy's in fifth, so he's doing very well.
Second last corner there. Araki-san.
Yeah, some new faces as well tonight. Okay, the penultimate lap for Wasim. Drifting or anything like that, keep it together.
Not yet, yeah. Don't want to make one of those showing off gone wrong videos.
Well, Wally has just said now that Flippy had a big crash on lap 2. So he'll definitely be happy with Flip with all the DCs.
Yeah, that's an excellent result if you take it into consideration, yeah. Mm. Did he also pull an ice cube or was it something different?
I've got no idea what happened with him. All I know is a big crash and
yeah. Right, looks like Wasim's coming up against the back marker. Hopefully this won't change anything, but he needs to be careful nonetheless.
So apparently his crash was at Oru. He crashed there and limped all the way around the track.
That's really not bad. I think we've all been there.
Yeah. And luckily I didn't do it in my race last week, Tuesday, but I've done it in a public lobby.
I think we all have.
Danadu drifting. Can Wasim get past? There we go, lovely. Moves out the way.
So we've got Casual Chris in 9th, and then we've got Isaac Blom running around in 10th position. And then Dana getting out of the way for PSNS to lap him. And as I say that Wasim is heading into the chicane, he will be starting his final lap. Right now.
Here we go. Lap.
He just needs to focus on keeping him on the track. No silly mistakes needed.
No waving to the crowd.
Just focusing on that line.
That's it.
Well, since he's passed PSNS, he hasn't given it his all to try and
get a gap. No, he hasn't been breaking any records. He has been consistent.
I mean, he knew he was in first already, so it was just a matter of just, you know what, let's just stick it on the tarmac and not go off track. And don't cause
Yeah, well, it's all the hard work that put him where he is now. He closed that gap very, very quickly. It was a perfect race, actually, considering what happened early on.
Well, he crashed on lap, I believe it was lap 3 or 4. He crashed. And to work his way back from that crash, that's definitely very good.
Well, it's drive of the day for sure.
No, who do you guys say is the driver of the day? Let's get those votes.
Yeah, I'm with Wazin on this one.
He's stuck between Wasim and Piers Neus, actually.
Yeah, I was also saying the same thing now. Piers Neus has also done very well. I mean, he was in first position from the start.
Well, he's secured P2 for sure, so still very nice.
And he didn't make any big mistakes. Yes, he went off track when Wasim caught up to him. But, I mean, other than that, I think he drove excellently.
Yeah, well, he managed to get himself out of trouble early on, which really paid dividends, and then he could just build from there. So he had a fantastic race, all in all. I think he will be super happy with P2.
Yes, definitely.
Here we go. Last time through the chicane. Don't.
He's not making any ice cube mistakes.
There we go. Lovely. Well done.
So he's a good move.
Coming over the line, and he has just won the race. Well done, Wilson. And we've got Pearson's coming over in a second position. We've got Raikusan in a third position.
Of course, not being able to catch him just yet. Looked like the gap was coming down a bit there.
The gap has definitely come down, but yeah, it hasn't come down fast enough.
Yeah. Losing out by a couple hundred meters there.
They're coming into the final chicane.
Raikusan also picking up P3 here. This is a good result.
Yeah, that is a very good result for me.
Definitely. At one point, looks to be going backwards. Yes. So. Picking up P3, very good there. Lose that in fourth. Caustic Raccoon, yeah. In the 4.58. Very nice.
And then Flippy coming through. Coming over in fifth position.
Sunny Memo drifting the last corner.
Coming over in sixth.
I think Sonny Mamel was the biggest loser from today, though. From where he was to where he's finished. That's unfortunate.
Yeah, we've got Cooker coming
through
in seventh
chicane.
Position.
That good sounding 10 cylinder. Oof, but Nubby Knuckles vet does sound good.
We've got Nutty Knuckles in the brilliant sounding Corvette coming in 8th position. Well, it doesn't look like there's any damage on his car, so he's also just stayed away from any trouble.
So good game plan. Avoid the drama.
And then Casual Chris is only going through a wreath right now. I believe this is his final lap. Still got three running. Oh, Casual Chris on the grass. Oh my word.
Brave. Ooh, a little bit of a lockup.
He's
actually a McLaren. I didn't even know there was a McLaren in this race.
I said that three times already today. Rowan, where are you listening?
My bad.
I was also surprised. I blame the lag. I was still even saying I'm surprised that anyone took the McLaren. Because
it's a Monday.
It used to be my go-to, yeah. Exactly. It used to be my go-to car in the... Oh, he's just hit the wall.
Yeah, it was. It was your fave for a long time.
Yeah.
Are you talking about this exact one, or did you have
this exact one? Yeah.
Okay,
yeah, that exactly. And it was very, I wouldn't say it was like the fastest car, but it was like a good all-rounder.
No, I was going to say, you never want to race with it.
Well, I remember last year when I started with the GT3 cars, I mean, back then, I didn't even know that you could actually turn the traction control off from this game. So when I joined the GT3 cars, I went through each and every single car around Laguna Seca, and I did probably more than 300 laps just in practicing and doing testing each car to see what I can do and which car will be handling better. And I have to say, the McLaren wasn't too bad. I mean, back then I didn't even realize the difference in speed in the cars. Just like, I needed a car that I can drive out of the corners without spinning.
Yeah.
That was all it was.
That's
about
the one you use the whole time.
Exactly. And I mean, look how far I've come right about now. I mean, I'm driving in the pros in the Lambo. And I mean, the Lambo is one of the most difficult cars to actually handle. So I'm quite impressed with myself.
Definitely right.
I must say, you're hitting the tires faster than ever.
And I've been hitting some tires, eh? I've been hitting some tires. So it's definitely, well, for everyone out there, it's doable to race yourself up. It just takes practice.
No, easily. I think the best thing to do is to race with other guys. The driver tires and that, they just get in the way.
Yes. And the thing with driver tires, they don't defend like real people will, so
yeah,
it's definitely it's better to thing.
They just block the racing line, they're very annoying.
Yeah, exactly. We've got Isaac Blom in a 10th position. He's definitely been in the war with that car. That Lambo's
good looking livery though.
It does look very good. And Gary did not give enough of a time.
Eight minutes I gave it.
Okay, it's not too bad.
It was a good amount of time, yeah. Saw some drifting near the end, so I think they also knew it wasn't enough.
Jeez, we had a few DCs in the end. Isaac Blom, Danadu, Albert, Springthorn, Bully.
Isaac and Danadu didn't finish the race because they didn't have time. But Albert, Springthorn, Bully, Ezekiel, and Colossus Wolf, we all lost due to
DCs or quits.
Well, I think Colossus couldn't get his car going after the huge crash.
And I think Albert's also after his little spin around there on the back straight.
Yes, maybe. That is perhaps.
If you guys got pictures of the results.
Yes, please make sure to send it to us. And I'm glad Wasim stayed in the full entire time.
Made it, yeah.
So yeah, got it.
Successful night.
Oh, they did a very good time there as well. 218.9.
I was saying there's some new names in the lobby as well, which is always good to see in the AMs.
Yes, it is. It means we grow.
Is that grassroots group?
But I'm very impressed with this AM race. I mean, the semi-pro guys had a huge incident that actually forced us to restart the race.
Yeah.
And with the AM group, yes, there was an incident, but it wasn't necessary to restart the race. I mean, even with the pro guys, there was an incident, but also not necessary to restart the race. So that's very good from these guys. I mean, I think the racing that we saw today, there's some good racing to come in the tracks left.
No, definitely. I think it's been a good one.
The standards race. Yeah, that's it.
The standards
that is us, I think.
Raised.
Yeah, but they have.
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
With every group, I mean, everyone just needs to step up to the next level. And I mean, it's not even only the pros or the semi-pros. It's every single group is needing to step up to show. I mean, Biesnes did a fantastic job today, getting second position. Raikusan, his second race back in Forza, and he picked up a third place. So it's definitely for the guys, the new guys and the old guys coming back. It's definitely there is a challenge, and it's good to see everyone.
It's going to be interesting to see the points. Yeah, that's for sure.
Yeah, that is.
I think no one expected these results.
Well, with a couple of guys missing, like Light Rich not racing tonight, he'll be losing out.
Yeah, true.
But then you've got guys like Piersnius and Wasim that's going to make up a lot of points with their finishes today.
I don't think everyone's going to be happy with the results, other than the guys at DC'd, obviously. Which is always a bit out of your control. But yes. I mean, yeah.
Unfortunate.
But yeah, it was a good night's racing. It wasn't too eventful, so I think we can end it there and call it a night.
Thank you guys for watching, and we'll catch you guys again. Thanks, guys.
We'll catch you in the next one.
Cheers.
Good night.
Cheers, guys.